babysitter.
Yeah, I was a babysitter for, that was my first career. Long time.
What age do you have to be to get the parents to trust you?
I think it varies. For children, mine was 12 because I remember making flyers that said 12-year-old CPR certified babysitter. And went down the street, and the lady said, I loved your flyers.
You were really, like, LinkedIn.
Yeah, and I got a Monday. I remember one-hour gig on a Monday. Every Monday, it was just a little, she would go to work, and the dad would come home a little later. So
there's a window.
And it was supposed to be $5, no, $2.50 or something.
For an hour?
That's
good money back then, I guess.
Back then, and I remember the guy would give me $5, and my mom would make me go back and walk over the change and say, nope. It's $2.50. She made me.
Come on, get a bonus.
Clink, clink. Oh. Yeah. And he'd go, no, seriously, it was awkward for him. And he's like, no, can you just keep the $5? No, my mom said I can't.
Well,
oh, God.
I tried,
Mom.
My mom
said I'm destined to be in debt.
He insisted that I keep it, Mom.
Right. Oh, I gave it to him, yeah.
I had an older sister. My sister Karen was 6 years older than me, so he had a built-in. Never really had anybody from outside coming over to babysit the brother.
It's exciting. It was fun.
I would think so.
When we got babysitters, we couldn't wait. It was a big night.
Our number is 410-338-1098. Maybe you were abused by your babysitter. Or maybe you were rude.
We don't want that big.
Well, listen.
Real abuse.
There was a movie that my son and I would watch called Monster House. Animated movie. And I guess 2 or 3 years ago, we would watch it every weekend when he came over. The movie, there's little kids and there's a house that is possessed. Mm-hmm. And the babysitter comes over because their parents leave. When the babysitter gets there, she's like, up to your room. Get up to your room. And they're like, no, we don't want to. She takes a plant and she throws it on the floor and breaks it and says, I tell your parents you did this.
What?
How about that? That's a bad babysitter right there. I thought, that's pretty brilliant. Who are they going to believe? They're going to believe the kid or are they going to believe the babysitter?
That would be a tough one.
Yeah.
I would want to believe my kid.
She takes that plant, bam, breaks it right on the floor. Oh, you want to do it again?
So I had a babysitter that we were in bed, but we were notorious for getting back up. You know, that's what you do as a kid.
You get in bed 8:30, 9 o'clock, and then you're back up again.
I can't sleep.
Right.
It's a move I'm familiar with now, recently.
Yeah.
But the babysitter was downstairs, and me and Lisa, my sister, went down there to tell her we were awake. And she was sitting in a moon chair, you know, those womb.
Big sort of beveled in.
Yeah, like a half moon. Half
circle. Yeah.
And she only had her bra on.
Just?
She was in jeans. And a bra.
Oh,
and she was just sitting there, and we were like, we were dying. And she, I'll never forget, she went, turn around. And she had, like, long red nails. And we were like, okay.
Yeah.
And then
she was getting serviced. Her boyfriend was hiding behind the couch. You know that.
Yeah, you know what? I don't remember. She might have not even had the bra on. Because I remember turning around, and she had to do something. Anyway, we told our parents as soon as
they got home.
Yeah. And she never came again. But we were like, we will not believe this. She
just
had a bra. We almost saw boobies.
Ooh.
Yeah, she must have had a boy over, maybe just hanging out with herself.
And how about
my parents could have come in.
They could have, but
maybe
she would have seen
the
car.
Yeah.
Or the headlights as they turn the corner and come up the road. But there's some babysitters that actually get a little relation going on.
Yeah. Invite a boy over?
No.
Oh, like with themselves?
No.
Okay.
With the kids that they're babysitting.
Oh, God.
Let's say the kid's 12, which is a little, that's old to be babysat, isn't it? 12?
Getting there.
Yeah.
Right.
And the babysitter's 15.
Right. Okay. Yeah, that's stupid.
Yeah.
Then you've got dumb parents, if that's what
right.
you do. Unless it's out of desperation, I guess, but.
Hey. I can leave my son alone for 2 hours now. 2 hours.
You know what? Now I'm thinking of it. A very, very, very handsome friend of mine lost his virginity to his babysitter.
Oh!
Yep. And he never told his mom or anything.
That's
crazy.
And
looking back, that's like 100% abusive.
It is. But if I was in that guy's position, I'd probably be like, bring it on. Come on.
I don't know. I don't know if that's the
way. Let's do it.
he felt.
No.
He probably was like, okay, you know, ugh, it's bad.
Yeah, when I was 14, the girl next door wasn't babysitter or anything, but she liked me, and she was older. She was probably 19, and I was 14. I talked a good game, but I was scared of
it. Yeah.
I wasn't ready yet. My pop-up timer hadn't popped.
No. And that's what she was looking for.
That's right. 410-338-1098. We got Melissa, Kirk, and Marianne. What up?
Hey, so yeah, crazy babysitters. When we were kids back in the 70s, we had a babysitter named Barbara who would come up, and she would allow my sister and I to smoke.
Whoa.
We were each allowed a half a cigarette. We had one of those pull-down attic ladders. She would pull down the attic ladder. She, my sister, and I would sit on the rafters up in the attic, and we would smoke. I think
and just
my
cough?
Sister and I were. No, never. But you know what's really funny is that I never, as an adult, smoked, or by the time I was a teenager, I never smoked. I was like, been there, done that.
How old were you?
We were like elementary school when she was doing this.
How are you not coughing up your beautiful pink lungs?
When I smoked at that age, I coughed every time I exhaled.
Yeah, that wouldn't be a fun memory.
Yeah, you were good.
Yeah.
I never coughed.
It's tough.
Yeah, as a result, I never smoked. But she did introduce, she would bring her albums. So Steve Miller Band, Joker.
Okay,
started listening to rock at a young age. So that was fun. So
all in all, good experience or bad experience?
Funny experience. It was the 70s. Chalk it up to life.
Yeah, chalk it up. Melissa.
Funny. Okay. Thanks
a
Melissa.
410-338-1098. Bad babysitter.